What is up, YouTube? We are going to be doing a little walkthrough here for Dark Souls 3. We're going to... this is really just more for fun. Nothing real serious going on here. We are going to be starting something new, going a little different route from my Let's Play. Indeed.
It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old word. Undead Legion, the Abyss Watchers. And the reclusive lord of the profaned capital. Yawn the Giant. Kindled will rise. Nameless, accursed undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh ember.
So don't worry too much if you have no idea what is going on with the storyline. The story in this game is not straightforward. You can play through the entire thing and have no idea what is going on. You kind of have to find it in bits and pieces, item descriptions, and a lot of it is just kind of mashed together theories. First thing we're going to do here is actually pick our class. I'm going to take a different approach. The knight is what most people consider to be the easiest as your first time playing. And I want to say, if this is your first time playing, understand that this game will be absolutely brutal in the beginning. It took me a couple hours to make it through the first area. And I hated it. I was so upset because I was so stoked for this game. And I was just upset at how ridiculously difficult it was. But once you get through it and once you start moving and you get used to how the gameplay works, it is just a beautiful, amazing, fun game. So I tried The Knight and I was not successful with it because it's really not my play style. So you really have to take into account your play style here. Most people consider The Knight to be the easiest because you see that vitality of 15. Now that means he has the ability to carry a lot of weight, and you see that with his armor there. He has the best starting armor. He has a 100% blocking shield. He has the best really starting items in the game. So next one here is our mercenary. This is what I started with. He's really a dexterity based character. You see that dexterity of 16. So the idea of being sort of quick and agile. The warrior is your next basic build, strength based. So heavy weapons, things like that. You see, he still has 11 in vitality, over one more than the mercenary, so he can carry some heavier weapons or heavier armor. The herald is a miracle melee hybrid. I don't really have any experience with the rest of these down on the list, but I may choose one of these. See, so a real quick overview of what all of these stats mean. So the level you're starting at is 9 with this one, 7, and so on. Vigor is directly related to how much health you have. Attunement is used in how many spells, miracles, or pyromancies you can have equipped, so you can switch between in battle. Endurance is directly related to how much stamina you have, so running, blocking, and attacks are all, and rolling are all based on your endurance. Vitality, again, is your equip load, so how much you can carry. And just for rule of thumb with vitality, keep it under 70%, or you become much slower when you try rolling. You get what's called fat rolling. Strength and dexterity are really the two main places you're going to put your points into, your souls into, for scaling up weapons. So obviously dexterity builds are going to be focused on dexterity, and strength on strength. Intelligence is the basis for sorcery. Faith is the basis for miracles. And luck is really more like item find. So you're a lot more likely to find good items when you kill people and such. It, however, is probably the least useful when we're talking about starting stats. So that's it. We got Herald. I'm not really thinking Thief or Assassin. Sorcerer, I know, is very difficult in the beginning before you get good spells. Pyromancer is sort of another hybrid, pyromancy and melee. Cleric is more a straightforward miracle build. And if this is your first time playing, do not play with Deprived at all. Let's see. I think we're gonna try the Herald. Let's go with Axis. Make you mature. Barrel gift. So none of these are particularly important. The life ring you can buy pretty early on in the game. It just raises your maximum HP, as it says there. I think I am going to start with the fire gem, so I immediately have that to infuse into my weapon. Presets, I usually go with presets because I don't know. I don't know. I care more about the gameplay than how I look. And if you become deprived, which I'll explain in a moment, you're going to end up looking like beef jerky anyway. I'm going to stick with basic. And we'll just go on from there so we can hop into it. So death in this game works differently than other games. When you die, you kind of reset to your last checkpoint or so on. Death is kind of normal in this game. You have what's called a dark sign, which means more or less you can't die. Every time you die, you come back to life. And if you have, in this game, if you have what's called a dark sigil, you become more hollowed, which more or less means you lose a little bit of yourself and you look more and more like beef jerky. A lot of the enemies you'll see in the game, especially in this first area, are actually people that are hollowed. They've slowly hollowed until they've become completely hollowed, and they're kind of mindless. So let's get into it. Okay, so here we are. These little red kind of slashes in the ground are actually notes. This is the tutorial area. There's not really any hand-holding in this game. It does not really show you how to do stuff. You have to learn on your own. So, real quick, R1 is a normal attack, R2 is a heavier attack. Shield. This particular shield has a parry ability. You see the up in the upper left-hand corner, we have our health gauge, our focus point gauge, and then our stamina in the bottom in green there. So as you notice, when we do something, our stamina depletes. We have run. One of the biggest things you use in the game is roll. You'll see me take full advantage of that. Don't really need to read these messages. So this guy is hollowed. Now, I'm starting off here with a spear. One of the advantages of a spear is it's the only weapon in a game where you can keep your shield up and still attack at the same time. Now, notice with my shield up, my stamina regenerates very slowly. So in a fight, if you're using a shield, you have to be aware of that and constantly be shield up, shield down to manage your stamina. Okay, this first right, there's no enemies back here. And you see our souls in the bottom right-hand corner. You get those for killing enemies. And also the little piece we picked up right there, that soul of a deserted corpse, we can use that to gain souls. When you die, you drop your souls and you have to get back to reclaim them. If you die again, you will lose them completely. See, we have a heal aid. The Estus Flask, you see equipped to my little bottom slot here is your health, and I'm about to pick up an Ashen Estus Flask, which will re replenish my focus points. You sneak up behind someone, you can get a critical. I actually missed it there. One of the most effective tactics in the game is to wait for someone to attack, roll around, got an arrow sticking out of me, roll around them, and then hit them. So, because this is third person, if you try and move backwards, you turn around, but when you're locked on someone, you can actually back up straight. Now, the checkpoints in this game are called bonfires. They will replenish all of your health and your Estus. And you can also fast travel between them. However, enemies all reset. So, for instance, this guy right here. Roll around him, hit him. Okay, so he died. Just got some souls for it. Now, if we rest at this bonfire, he is back again. Ooh. All about rolling. Okay, so we made our way over here. When those guys are sitting down like that, you can't target them until they start to get up. Be careful. When I went after this one, the other one didn't stand up, but they usually do. Be careful for this guy. He's hiding around the corner. Same thing here. Now, what you may miss is that there is a little pathway right here. Now, at the bottom, there is going to be two guys. One with a crossbow there in the back. And this guy up front with a shield and spear, similar to you. Keep that shield up to try and avoid any hits from that crossbow. There we go. We're going to go for this guy. Away from that attack. Ooh. Ugh, he used an Estus flask too. There we go. Kill him before he gets another chance to shoot. And this is going to be 5 firebombs. So, like I said, when you die, you go back to a bonfire. It's like your checkpoint, but it's not like a normal game. If I use a firebomb and I die, I've used it. There's no going back. There's never going back in this game. So keep that in mind when you make decisions. So I'm going to equip those firebombs so I can have access to them quickly. See, I can toggle to them here. We're actually going to go over here. We're going to try and make this jump. While we're running, if you click the left stick, you jump. There is not much in the realm of jumping in this game. You can't really, you know, if you see like a little ledge like that, there's no way you're jumping up on it. And if you're above someone, you can get a critical by dropping on them. So you can get criticals in the game by dropping on someone, executing what's called a backstab. See if I can get it here. He'll stop to fire on me. Like that. Or you can, if you get someone in what's called like a broken stance, so you deplete all of their stamina, or you parry an attack, it will put them in a vulnerable state, and you can get a critical in front of them, what's called a riposte. So we are going to, so this is all there is for the tutorial area. And next we're going straight into the first boss. So we're gonna do our best to not get hurt at all. So, you have the chance to beat him the best the first time. And the reason for that is you can get a few free hits in here before he gets up. So as soon as you pull that sword out, get as many hits in there as you can, and then get out of the way. We're actually gonna see. I'm hoping I can get a parry on him. I haven't parried in a long time. Ooh. Nah, let's just dodge. And you really want to watch out for his grab. And I'm not doing a good job of keeping that shield up. There was the grab. Ooh. I didn't see that one coming. So with rolling, if you do it at the right time, ooh, which I am not, you're pretty much invulnerable. So I just used my miracle there. Help avoid using some Estus. Ooh. Okay. So this is his second stage. And he is a lot more aggressive in this stage. First try. Now I can pretty much guarantee you that it will not be that easy. So some tips for that one is you have the best chance right at the beginning. Get those free hits in there. If you can parry him in the beginning, that is also good. If you don't get through it the first time, that's okay. Don't worry about it. Trust me, I must have done this 40 times before I got it once. Now, some other tips are when he goes into transforming to that second stage, you want to stick close to him in the first stage, because when he goes into that, you can get some more free hits in on him before or while he's transforming. In the second stage, he becomes a lot more aggressive. If you back off, he has some big lunging attacks. He'll jump all the way across towards you. You just need to get used to timing those dodges, those rolls. Okay, so this is our second bonfire. First boss is complete. Oh, one other thing. He is weak to fire. So those fire bombs could be put to some use. Or if you're a pyromancer, that would also work well. So here, we're going to fast travel back. Oh, we cannot fast travel yet. I guess we have to make it to the Firelink Shrine first, which is just the next area. Now, there was an area that I skipped initially. Ooh, that was bad. And we're gonna go back for that now that we've completed the first boss. Let's run by everyone. Now, sometimes if you're engaged in battle, it won't let you rest at a bonfire, so keep that in mind. Go back to the tutorial area. So, down this path is what's called a Ravenous Crystal Beast, and it's not as hard as the boss, but it is going to be pretty darn difficult if this is your first time playing. You see there's an item over there. So again, it's all about the dodging and the rolling. Now, he has a lot of health. Ooh, that hurt. Also, real quick, in case I die, gonna talk about a couple things. If you look at my health, you notice I have a lot more than I did before, and if you look to the left of it, the symbol's red. That's because when I killed the boss, I entered what is called an embered state. You get 30% more health. And there are a few other things that come along with it, but that's really the main one, is the health. When you die, you do not lose items you've picked up. So if you want the item in here, your best bet is to run in and grab it the very first thing when you start the game. It doesn't matter if you die, you lose whatever small amount of souls are there, just leave them and then go about the rest of it. However, killing this Ravenous Crystal Beast will drop a nice upgrade material. So you want to kill him if you can. Oh man, I am not doing well. Ugh, get out from... Watch out for that ice attack. Ugh. You want to do a lot of strafing. Try and get him out here in the middle. Let's just move around to the side. Ooh. Not doing so well. It's about as much health as we're gonna juice out of that. So I might have to try this again. Ooh. I thought he was trying to stomp. Oh man, I am doing terrible. It's okay. You'll get in a good example of what happens when you die and you drop your souls. Okay. So I've died, so I'm going to come back at the last bonfire that I rested at. But you will notice I will have no souls. And because I died, I also lost my embered state. Throughout the game, that will restore that. You should see my souls on the ground as this green little, you see it right there. Looks like an item, but green. Run over, claim them. Go ahead and grab this item. It's just a soul. Try not to get killed. Oh my goodness. What's funny here is I actually had a lot easier time with this guy than I did the first boss. Oh, woo. So you get those attacks in there, you strafe and dodge. You gotta watch out for that one. Because if you're too close to that, you'll still get hit by the ice. Ooh. Since I'm not using my shield very much, I'm gonna dual wield my weapon so it does something like 50% more damage. It does move a little slower. Just gonna keep doing that, just strafing and hitting him when we can. Oh, we staggered him there. Ooh. Yeah, you don't want to be too aggressive. Just take it nice and slow and get those shots in there when you can. Wait for him to give you an opening. Like right there is a good one. Got three hits in there because I saw he was doing a ice attack. Ooh. Okay. Time to get out of there. Crap. Ooh. Almost there. Oh man. So close. Okay, well, we're gonna wrap this up right here, and when we come back, we will kill him and move on to Firelink Shrine. Thank you for watching. Please hit subscribe.